Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all our sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. That's Psalm 103, verse 2 to 5. And he writes, in difficult times like these, it is easy to focus on our problems, overlook all the good things God has done and is doing. Don't. He has forgiven our sins. He's lifted us from the pits of life. He fills our lives with love. He has healed our bodies, fulfilled our passions with good things, and blessed us with feelings of being young again. Let's face our challenges today filled with satisfaction of his presence and confidence in his benefits toward us. It's a good reminder as we face a lot of different things today. Again, an unusual day such as we've never really lived through before. But God is faithful, isn't he? Amen? And as we set our hearts on him, he puts all things in right place. He takes us from distraction, distress, you name it, anxiety, fears, and he puts us in a place where we can experience his peace. So I'd invite you to come join me in that place today as we begin our worship together. And let's experience God's power and love in this time. As we gather, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name. Knowing well, as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. We'll be blessed because we came. As we gather, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name. Knowing well, as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. Well, as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came. We'll be blessed because we came. Bless your holy name. the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy
faithfulness, morning by morning. for sin and a peace that endures. Blessings all mine with 10,000 besides.
Sing it with me.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
That they have. And then there's songs as I'm praying and putting their time together where Holy Spirit says, make sure this one shows up. It's just what I call wait a minute songs. For me, they're anthems of worship or declarations of the goodness of God that cause my soul to pause for a moment, to reflect on the truth that God is faithful, that God is good, that God is mighty, that God is enduring, all of these things that we need reminding of. And this morning, earlier, as I was looking at Psalms, this one really stuck to my soul. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. What, even when COVID is doing its thing in our nation? Yes, he never ceases to be steadfast and loving. Even when we can't get back into the building, yes, he's steadfast and he's loving. Even when my finances are tight and I don't know how I'm going to make ends meet, God is steadfast. His mercies, they don't end. They're new every morning, and we need to turn our face toward him and say, Lord, I know you're good. I know you're faithful. I trust you. Make those declarations. Let your faith rise up. It only needs to be the size of a mustard seed. And speak out into the atmosphere. God is providing my needs. God is restoring my health. God is renewing my peace. Speak it out in the atmosphere. The enemy can't stand it when the children of God praise him in spirit and truth, when they worship in spirit and truth. Come with me to that place this morning.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Of the Lord never ceases, his mercies never come.
Declarations out in faith this morning. If you agree with me that God is faithful, hit that love button. You're not loving me, you're loving the Lord. We see a whole barrage of people hitting that love declaration. That it's an amen. It's a so be it unto the Lord. You are new every morning and your faithfulness is here and endures. Yeah, that's what I want to see. All those declarations. Agreement in the Spirit.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I proved Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him. So sweet just to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to rest on His promise, just to know thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. His cleansing blood, just in simple faith to plunge me, leave His healing cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus.
precious Jesus, Savior friend. And I know thou art with me, will be with me to the end. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I've proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Oh, for grace to trust him more. Sometimes sometimes praise the Lord, sometimes gently singing, hearts in one accord. Oh, let us lift our voices. Sky and start to sing. Oh, let us now return his love. Just let our voices ring. Let us feel his presence. Praises fill the air. Let us sing the song of Jesus' love to people everywhere. Sometimes hallelujah, sometimes praise the Lord, sometimes gently singing, our hearts in one accord. Let our joy be unconfined. Let us sing with freedom unrestrained. Let's take this feeling that we're feeling now. Outside these walls, let it rain. Let the Spirit overflow. We love you, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. We want this world to know. Sometimes, hallelujah, sometimes praise the Lord. You know, I was pondering things as I worship. The Lord stirs things in my heart. I'm sure it's the same for you. And a thought came to me from a quote that I heard a long time ago, that before we touch people in this world today, we should allow Holy Spirit to touch us. It's a simple little thought, but a powerful impact. Before we touch the world around us, we should let the Lord touch us. Before we step out into the day, we need to step in with Him. And that influence of God, of His Holy Spirit filling us and overflowing us, will change the way that we touch the world. Do you know what I'm talking about? Do you know what I'm speaking of? When we allow Holy Spirit to touch us first, then we step out into this world, our touch is sweet, our touch is healing, our touch is redeeming. It might be something simple. You know, we were at a restaurant the other day after spending a few hours in worship and praise, and outside, you know, because you can't really crowd, and we were outside, and the order didn't come out very good or very well, and we in our hearts decided to not be a problem for this waitress who was dealing with so many others. It seems people are coming out of their homes and they're not coming out with joy, they're coming out with almost a venom or a pent-up anger. And so we didn't complain or anything, and when she went to pack up the rest of her order, she asked if it was okay, and we had to be honest and said, well, this thing wasn't so well, but don't worry about that, we're okay. You know, that's not a problem. We really enjoyed being here, and we enjoyed the meal, the part that we had. And she was so relieved, and she came back a little while later with the biggest cannoli you've ever seen in your life. It was just a sweet little treat, you know. She said, thank you. You were so nice to me. And you never know what a little thing will do. And when we allow the Lord to touch us first, we step out with His touch for the world around us. And next time it may be someone who's broken in spirit. Maybe they're devastated, loss of a loved one. Who knows what their need is, but God will use you to touch them. We need to let our joy be unconfined. We shouldn't hold it in. We should let it come out. We need to let the Spirit of God move in us and through us. Amen. So I'm going to do that second verse again. Why don't you join me? Maybe you don't know it, but listen to the words and then join me in the chorus. Oh, let our joy be unconfined. Let us sing with freedom unrestrained. Let's take this feeling that we're feeling now. Outside these walls, let it rain. Oh, let the Spirit overflow. We are filled from head to toe. We love you, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. We want this world to know. Sometimes, hallelujah. Sometimes, pray. Sometimes gently sing, our hearts in one accord. Sometimes, alleluia. Sometimes praise the Lord. Sometimes gently sing, our hearts in one accord. Thank you, Jesus. I encourage you to do a watch party with the live stream today. Maybe that's going to be your ministry today, to invite friends that you have on your Facebook into an atmosphere of the Lord's presence and glory. You can quit the stream, come back on, and do it with a watch party. You'd be amazed at who joins you today. Let that be your ministry, and let it at least begin right there today. Is extravagant. find I'm moving to the rhythms of your grace. Your fragrance is intoxicating in our secret bliss. Your love. No greater love have I ever known. You consider me a friend. Spread wide the arms of Christ. It's the love that covers sin. Is the love that covers sin.
Holy,
shelter like no other. Your name, let the nations sing it louder. Nothing has the power to save but your name.
King of all kings. Thank you, Jesus. as my soul does, burn within. I live in Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
In this place.
Come on, let's just worship Him.
And I feel something about us. like the fragrance after the rain. Jesus, 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 little
I
Yes, I exalt thee. I exalt thee. I exalt thee. Oh,
I'm encouraged in my soul and my spirit to worship Him with you this morning. Thanks for being here. Thank you for joining me. And for those of you who are doing watch parties, thank you for extending the worship and the praise and the atmosphere to others. After this is over, I'll download it and post it for those who have a hard time connecting through Facebook. Feel free to share it with others. I'm not trying to promote myself or anything that I'm doing, but I know that right now that's so important for people to spend time in the very presence of the living God, season their soul, their whole demeanor with Him, that when we start the day, we have a touch from the Lord, so that when we go out into the day, we can touch others with the Lord. Amen. So Lord bless you, make His face to shine upon you. May the Lord give you His favor, His wisdom, His anointing, as you touch others in this world today. Exalt Him through your life, and let it be for His glory. Can you say amen with me? Amen. Lord willing, we'll connect again with you this evening for our worship and word at 6:15. This evening, we'll, as we have so many times before, we'll praise the Lord together for a while. Pastor Jeremy will bring the word this evening. Looking forward to that. He's such a wonderful young man, and his family, a blessed family. And I just enjoy the richness of his life as he pours the word out. So join us this evening, and we'll look forward to having you with us again. God bless you. Have a blessed day.